tire shandy. How's it going? Good.
Starting to get warm out there in the sun.
A little bit. Nice deal.
Right, 1918.
1.5 Mercury. Hey, how are you doing?
Going around making my videos. How are you?
Good.
Good to see you today.
You running that little engine?
What's that?
You been running that little engine?
Yeah, we ran it a little bit last night.
Good. It's a great display you have there. How are you doing? Nice to see you again. I'll be sitting down right here in a few minutes. This is a great water pump display. Water pumps are featured here this year at Tumble. Waterloo boy. Right in the middle comes gas.
No,
to make a little short video of Don's engine. Copper cooled domestic. This one is 7 knots. Hi, Harold. Look at that. Hi, Danny. How are you? Good. A little warm, but it's warm where I came from, too. Yeah. Boy, that's as smooth and quiet as they get, isn't it? Now, I was looking at my pictures. I was looking at the pictures I took of this.
Oh.
Yeah. And it is a parcelling weed, not a weed.
No, I don't know.
You're right. It's a parcelling weed.
Yeah, but a guy told me this morning.
Yeah.
That was made by the Franklin Motor Company.
Right, Franklin. Yeah. Franklin.
Franklin.
Yeah, they made the parcelling weed engines for a long time.
He has that name on the cylinder. Not on this one.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's a parcelling weed design, and that's those two flywheels in the middle.
Yeah.
Each one's one of the crank arms.
Well, you don't have no brake cap.
Right.
I mean, you don't need to make a crank cap.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's quite a piece. Nice and quiet. Yeah, that's a nice speed. Here's a little new hop.
Scale of a half horse new hop.
Parcelling weed. It's been highly modified by our friend Harold's dad, Dick Siebert. He added a side shaft. He made all the parts for it, or acquired them and added them to it. He added a side shaft, which has 7 or 8 jobs. The shaft will run the water pump, keep it cool. And here you have a distributor drive. It has an ignition off an antique inboard motorboat motor, and here's an oiling system, kind of like what you find on the old autos. And it drives the governor, which is right here. And you move along up the wall, it drives this here. There's a fuel pump. And here's the rocker arm for the exhaust valve. And here's the the rocker and cam for the intake valve. Here's the rocker. There. And there's a magneto on the front, which is not hooked up today. It's running off.
Fudge coil you see right down there.
There's a screen cooler on the back. Right now this looks like a lubricator. It's a fuel supply. Running on gasoline. There's the carburetor over there. And that just about completes the tour of this pretty complex little engine. And here's a nice display of domestic water pump. You too. Today. Here's a 2-horsepower Famous, tank cooled. Here's another. 3-horsepower fan. There's a air-cooled Waterloo boy right there. Here's a 3-horsepower Fairbanks Morse. Engine. 4-horsepower clips. How about this? A part chrome plated associated Johnny on the spot. Back for these fine models. Scale domestic mudsucker. Here's a Jacobson. Nice model. Here's a full-size here's a full-size domestic. Pumping water. And how about that? An international harvester type. Here's a 1.5-horsepower domestic stovepipe from about 1915. Nice running engine. Here's a 1.5 domestic stovepipe push rod engine. Running a water pump, one of the features. Yes. Don't worry. Let's go to the next.